We're given a 3x3 matrix and asked to write the matrix in reduced row echelon form. So for a quick review, these four conditions must be met for a matrix to be in reduced row echelon form. Number one, the first non-zero element in each row, called the leading entry, must be a 1. 2, each leading entry, or 1, is in a column to the right of the leading entry, or 1, in the previous row. 3, rows with all zero elements, if any, are below rows having a non-zero element. 4, in each column that contains a leading entry or 1, all other elements of the column are zeros. So here are two examples of 3x3 matrices in reduced row echelon form. Notice this 3x3 matrix is the identity matrix, and this 3x3 matrix is not. The reason I mention this now is because if an n-by-n matrix A is invertible, or non-singular, meaning it has an inverse, then matrix A in reduced row echelon form would be equal to the identity matrix. And if the n-by-n matrix is not invertible or singular, meaning it does not have an inverse, then matrix A in reduced row echelon form would not be equal to the identity matrix. So let's begin by performing row operations to write this matrix in reduced row echelon form. Let's first obtain a 0 in this position here. Notice 2 times negative 2 plus 4 would be 0. So let's replace row 3 with 2 times row 3 plus row 2. Notice how all the elements in row 2 have a common factor of 2. Let's replace row 2 with 1/2 times row 2. So row 1 will stay the same. Multiplying row 2 by 1/2 would give us 2, 5, negative 5. And now we're going to replace row 3 with 2 times row 3 plus row 2. So 2 times negative 2 plus 4, that's 0. 2 times negative 3 plus 10 is positive 4. And 2 times 7 plus negative 10 is positive 4. Now let's work on obtaining a 0 in this position and this position. Notice how there's a 4 here in row 3, and 3 times 4 is 12. 12 plus negative 12 would be 0. So let's replace row 1 with 3 times row 3 plus row 1. Now looking at this 2 and this negative 10, notice that 5 times 2 plus negative 10 would be 0. Let's replace row 2 with 5 times row 2 plus row 1. Notice here we have 2 4s. Let's replace row 3 with 1/4 times row 3. So again, row 1 is replaced with 3 times row 3 plus row 1. So 3 times 0 plus negative 10 is negative 10. 3 times 4 is 12 plus negative 12 is 0. 3 times 4 is 12 plus 38, that's 50. Now we'll replace row 2 with 5 times row 2 plus row 1. So 5 times 2 plus negative 10 is 0. 5 times 5 plus negative 12 is positive 13. 5 times negative 5 plus 38 is also 13. Multiplying row 3 by 1/4, we would have 0, 1, 1. I think we almost have it now. Notice row 1 has a common factor of 10. Let's replace row 1 with negative 1/10 times row 1. So this first element is positive 1. Let's replace row 2 with 1/13 times row 2. And to obtain a 0 in this position here, let's use row 2 and row 3. Let's replace row 3 with negative 13 times row 3 plus row 2. Notice negative 13 times 1 plus 13 is equal to 0. So negative 1/10 times row 1 is 1, 0, negative 5. 1/13 times row 2 would be 0, 1, 1. And now we'll replace row 3 with negative 13 times row 3 plus row 2. So we'd have negative 13 times 0 plus 0 is 0. Negative 13 times 1 plus 13 is 0. And again, negative 13 times 1 plus 13 is 0. Notice how this matrix is now in reduced row echelon form. We have the row of zeros at the bottom. The leading entry in row 1 and row 2 are 1s. The remaining elements in those columns are 0. And the 1 in row 2 is to the right of the 1 in row 1. Notice how this matrix in reduced row echelon form does not equal the identity matrix, which means the given matrix is not invertible or singular, meaning it does not have an inverse. I hope you found this helpful.